Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. Libby Purves has accused the BBC of virtue signalling, as the broadcaster refuses to make white, male comedy in a drive to become more diverse. The broadcaster lamented the corporation's PC panic, which she claims has resulted in rules and fences being erected around what shows can and can't be made. British radio presenter, journalist and author, Libby Purves, 68, made comedy, has no race, tribe or gender. Miss Purves, 68, said it has become increasingly fashionable to attack white, educated, straight, affluent men who earn £200,000 a year. Though describing this attitude as bigotry, she maintained it could have a positive impact on diversity, the gender pay gap and racism. But she argued that there are areas where pious, reverse discrimination becomes plain potty. Writing in Radio Times, the journalist said her heart sank when BBC comedy boss Shane Allen said last month that Monty Python would not have been commissioned today because the show was made up of six Oxbridge white blokes. Women too greedy for Have I Got News with two white middle-aged men for team captains. It hardly ticks the BBC's boxes for equality. But Have I Got News for You has been defended by one of its producers, who claims women refuse to appear on the panel show because they're too greedy. Joe Bunting, who has worked on it for 13 years, said most women will only appear if they can be that week's guest host because it pays more. She said politicians such as Tory MP Anna Sobry had been invited endless times, but many want to be the host due to their egos. She told Radio Times, "The other thing is money, I suppose. You get paid a lot more. They're not stupid and they're quite greedy." She also said only certain people are suitable for taking on the role of the host, adding, "I want the lights to come up and you see who the guest host is and you think, ooh, it's Joe Brand or Alexander Armstrong. I don't think people are going to say, ooh, brilliant, it's Anna Sobry. Is there any spectacle more depressing, more Dad Dance and David Brent, than an artfully subtled BBC commissioner smugly bigging up his diversity cred?" Miss Purves asked. Worse still when he is the controller through whom all new comedy must pass. For him the metropolitan, educated experience is out, also the male middle-aged life crisis, hard luck Hancock and Reggie Perrin. Instead he promised an authentic Muslim experience, mental health issues and the all-black family. The presenter bemoaned the way the corporation is building a world of rules and formulae and fences, even around laughter. She added, "I suspect the commissioner of comedy is just virtue signaling in some internal PC panic." Miss Purves went on, "We all need to laugh, and the idea that we can only be made to do so by people exactly like us is just weird. For the gift of provoking laughter, the main point, even of the most barbed satire, is elusive. It follows no strict social immoral laws. Not everyone laughs at all of it, some are offended, but it has no race, tribe, gender or age." Miss Purves also claimed that the Python's characters are of businessmen, generals, bosses, doctors, silly walkers and nudge-nudge lectures were all a good takedown of the much maligned, stale pale male establishment. Python star John Cleese reacted to Mr. Allen's comments by writing on social media, "Unfair. We were remarkably diverse for our time. We had three grammar school boys, one a poof, and Gilliam, though not actually black, was a Yank. And no slave owners." Miss Purves also accused Mr. Allen of being inconsistent, pointing out that just 2 years ago he launched a landmark sitcom season, which included remakes of classics such as Porridge.